Hey there, welcome back to our channel. Have you ever wondered what it would be like to age rapidly? Imagine being a child but looking like you're in your 80s. This isn't a plot from a sci-fi movie, but a real condition called progeria. Today, we're diving deep into this rare genetic disorder. We'll explore what causes it, how it's detected, and what's being done to help those affected. So let's get started on this journey to understand progeria. Progeria, or Hutchinson-Gilford progeria syndrome, is an incredibly rare condition. It affects about 1 in 4 million newborns worldwide. The name comes from two doctors who first described it in the late 1800s. Children with progeria age much faster than normal. They often look like tiny older people. Let's talk about what causes this condition. It all comes down to a change in a gene called LMNA. This gene is responsible for making a protein called lamin A. Lamin A is important for keeping the shape of a cell's nucleus. In progeria, there's a mistake in this gene. This mistake leads to the production of an abnormal protein called progerin. Progerin messes up the structure of the cell nucleus. This causes cells to become unstable and age too quickly. Here's an interesting fact. The genetic change in progeria usually happens by chance. It's not typically passed down from parents to children. That's why it can appear in families with no history of the condition. Now let's talk about how doctors spot progeria. Early detection is crucial, but it's not always easy. The first signs can be subtle and easily missed. Babies with progeria often grow slowly and gain weight slowly. They might start losing their hair and body fat. Their skin may look older than it should. As they get older, children with progeria develop a distinct look. They often have a small face, thin lips, and a nose that looks beaked. Doctors use genetic testing to confirm a progeria diagnosis. A simple blood test can spot the LMNA gene change. For families with a history of progeria, there are prenatal tests available. These tests can check if an unborn baby has the gene change. While there's no cure for progeria yet, there are ways to help manage it. In 2020, a drug called lonafarnib was approved to treat progeria. It's the first medication specifically for this condition. Lonafarnib helps reduce the buildup of the abnormal progerin protein. This can improve some of the heart problems linked to progeria. Children with progeria need a lot of support. They often work with many different doctors. These might include heart doctors, growth specialists, and skin doctors. Physical therapy helps keep their joints flexible. Nutritionists make sure they're getting enough calories to grow. Regular heart checkups are important because heart disease is a big risk. Let's hear from some experts in the field. Dr. Leslie Gordon is a leading researcher in the field of progeria and co-founder of the Progeria Research Foundation. She's also the co-founder of the Progeria Research Foundation, says,
"Progeria research has made significant strides in recent years, thanks to the collective efforts of scientists, clinicians, and families. Our understanding of the disease mechanism has opened new avenues for treatment, and ongoing clinical trials continue to offer hope."
So she emphasizes the importance of a collaborative approach in tackling this condition. Cardiologist Dr. Mark Kieran, who has worked extensively with progeria patients, says,
"Children with progeria are at a significantly higher risk for heart disease and stroke at a very young age. Regular cardiovascular assessments and early interventions are critical in managing these risks and prolonging life expectancy."
So he highlights the cardiovascular challenges these children's scientists, doctors, and families face all working together. Their efforts have led to big steps forward in understanding and treating progeria. Geneticist Dr. Francis Collins, who was instrumental in identifying the LMNA mutation responsible for progeria, emphasizes,
"Identifying the genetic basis of progeria has not only provided insights into the aging process, but also paved the way for potential treatments. The progress we've made exemplifies the power of genetic research in transforming patient care."
So he points out that heart problems are a major concern and underscores the value of genetic research in understanding and combating rare diseases. Children with progeria have a high risk of heart disease and stroke at a young age. That's why regular heart checkups are so important. Scientists are always looking for new ways to help those with the condition. They're working on better treatments and hoping to find a cure. So there you have it, a deep dive into progeria. It's a rare condition, but understanding it is important. It helps us learn about aging and how our genes work. More importantly, it helps us support those living with progeria. If you found this video interesting, please give it a like. Don't forget to subscribe for more health and science content. Have any questions about progeria? Leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.